If you've been wondering about the difference between an Echeveria elegans and an Echeveria glauca, then look no further. This video is for you. Hello and welcome back to my garden. My name is Chuck and I'm going to walk you through the differences between the two plants. Under ideal conditions, they look so different and they can be easy to tell apart. But who knows, maybe in less than ideal conditions, they would look a bit similar, hence the confusion in some people. Now to fix that problem, I present to you four ways to tell them apart. Number one, color. Both of these plants are glaucous, which means that they are dull grayish green and blue. The elegans gets a bit more pale as it receives more sunlight. The margins are a bit translucent and can get reddish, especially in winter. On the other hand, glauca, as the name suggests, it is very glaucous, but compared to the elegans, it turns more green or blue as the sun gets more intense. The edges are a bit reddish and this can get a bit more intense during winter. Number two, rosette. The elegans is a very dense rosette and it can have anywhere between 80 to 100 leaves when fully grown. And as you can see, it forms a compact and ball-shaped structure like this one, especially as it gets more light. In reverse, when it doesn't get enough sunlight, of course, the leaves start laying flat. But otherwise, you'll still see the same ball-like structure. The glauca is also a dense rosette. It can have anywhere between 40 to 50 leaves when it's mature enough. The outermost leaves are almost always laying flat, even with enough sunlight, unless they are in tight clumps like this one, in which case, they are pushing against each other. Number three, leaf shape. With the elegans, the apex of the leaf is broad and forms a mucronet tip, and that means that it ends abruptly with a sharp point. With the glauca, the lower part is narrow and cuneate, which means that it is wedge-shaped. Here's a couple of leaves, one from each plant, and based on the description I gave so far, would you be able to tell them apart? So which one of these two is the glauca, and which one is the elegans? Now let's see if you got it right. To the left, this is the glauca, and to the right, this is the elegans. Again, based on the description I gave earlier, the glauca has a wedge-shaped base, so it's more narrow at the base and goes wider as we reach the apex. The elegans, on the other hand, is almost the same throughout. And if you look at the apices of both, the elegans has a rounded tip, which abruptly ends into this sharp little bit right here. The glauca, on the other hand, is more acute, and the sharp tip is more defined. If we flip them over, another way to tell them apart is that the glauca leaves are thinner compared to the elegans. And for the fourth method, that would be the flowers. My plants don't have flowers right now because it's in the middle of winter. Flowers come out late winter or early spring. But I do have lots of older photos from previous seasons and we can refer to that. Regarding the flowers, both of them are second, which means that the flowers are all on the same side rather than being all over the place. Their flowers look a bit similar, but there's an easy way to tell them apart, and that's by the density of the flowers. The elegans flowers sparsely and it's usually just having 5 to 7 flowers per stalk. On the other hand, the glauca is really dense, having about 12 to 20 flowers from a single stalk. If you enjoy this comparison video, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell. That way you won't miss out on any future comparison videos. You could also check out my Instagram at @seriscapades. I post an Echeveria plant every single day under the hashtag DailyEcheveria. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!